Charity hockey tournament benefiting the Children's Hospital of Orange County. My grandfather was the most amazing man I've ever met. He passed away of a rare cancer of the blood, so we wanted to commemorate this tournament in his honor. We have lots of things going on. One, you can play hockey. Two, you can walk around and enjoy all the entertainment that we have and the different vendors. Or three, you can give blood. A lot of people bleed in hockey, so we kind of went off that idea of giving blood and playing hockey in the area and around the country. Blood is always needed, and it's really important that people give. At this year's tournament, we have 84 teams, which is approximately 650 hockey players. We also have about 2,000 spectators that come through during the weekend, and our goal is to hopefully get 200 pints of blood. Coke donated all our drinks so we can sell them for as much as we want, and as much as we can sell, we get to keep.
I'm Skyler Lahore, Rink Rat Hockey, member of Team Mission Axiom, and you're watching RollerHockeyTV.net.
Hi, I'm Svetlana from Russia.
I'm Irina.
Смотрите RollerHockeyTV.net.
Hi, this is Christina Caney from Zamboni Company and Zamboni Kitty Rides. This is from RollerHockeyTV.net.
...100% roller hockey focus. This gives us the ability to evolve and develop roller hockey products at a higher level than ever before. The game is changing every day. As the market leader, the customer has a growing expectation for innovative hockey concepts and more compelling products. We decided that ventilation was going to be our focal point, and we wanted to apply it aggressively to all categories. We wanted to achieve this through true technology upgrades and a design approach that would change the way skates are designed forever. An asymmetrical approach allowing for a unique look and feel. And this has been spread throughout all product categories, highlighting new features and technology. We needed to revive our identity as a true roller hockey company, getting back to our old mentality of game-specific performance concepts. We needed to get back to being a mission.
Wow, you guys do it every year.
When I look at this, I just
rep standpoint, I'm thinking, chicka-ching-ching, ching. I can't wait to get these skates. This is by far the best skates I've ever seen.
What I've always liked about Mission is that they push limits. They go places that other companies can't or won't.
Mission is always on the cutting edge. When people buy a Mission product, they want to have something different.
I love seeing the excitement from my buyers when I bring new product in. As soon as you roll those bags in, they can't wait to see what you've got, because they know that you're upping the game every time you walk through that door with the product that's in your bag.
And this is definitely what the hardcore roller hockey player is looking for. This is amazing. I can't wait to get my sample and hit the road with this.
Eleven years of growth with our program, with Mission being a major backer of us, is the pride factor, the respect. They've gone out of their way to make sure that we're taken care of, the kids are looked after, and the parents get a great bargain for the buck.
What I see with Bauer and Mission and with USA Clinics is a continual growth for creating hockey players, and really this hockey community that's a small niche of like-minded individuals that get along. So
it's pure excitement that comes to mind. It's just it's like a 60-year-old man when they drive a new Ferrari. Sometimes it's uncontrollable with these guys. They're just like a bumblebee with one wing and a jam job. And for these guys to wear the stuff, you know, you feel good, you look good, you play good.
Kids are seeing, it's sick. They put it on, it's comfortable, they like the stiffness. They're going out there, and the first thing was, I want a pair of these skates, I want it now.
If I can think about only one word about the new Inatter series, it's completely insane.
Ladies and gentlemen, from State Wars, we have Mr. Tim McManus.
Hey, Doug, how are you?
Very good, thank you. And Tim's just coming off the heels of State Wars number 8, which was in St. Louis, Missouri. Tim, tell us a little bit about the event. I heard you had record numbers, fantastic turnout. Give us the lowdown on everything that happened.
Yeah, we had our biggest and best tournament to date. We had 280 teams participating from 30 different states and provinces. 200 of those teams were youth teams. It was a sold-out event for 12 days. Just a great, competitive, awesome event.
If you've ever been a part of State Wars, you know how professionally it's run. Tim's staff, he spares no expense, bringing some of the best tournament directors out there. Every rink is staffed, the evaluations, everything you do. Tim, when you came up with the concept State Wars, let's go back into history. What was your motivating factor?
You know, we wanted to make sure we could have an event that's competitive and that teams could, you know, play for their home state or province, show a lot of pride, self-pride of where they come from. and not just be just another tournament where teams are put together from all over the place. We wanted kids to come out and just represent their home state or their province and just feel a lot of pride in where they come from.
And one of the things, I, being a state director for California, we had such a great time out there. Every event I went to, I got to go to Hawaii because of State Wars. You get to work with some great people. When you go to State Wars, like you said, you put that jersey on, there's a lot of pride involved. And you must be very proud of the fact that you've created that.
Yeah, you know, very proud. It's always exciting. You know, people really have bought into the concept of representing where they come from. I know I'm very proud of where I come from, and I think most people are. And it's, you know, it's a different event. It's very unique, but it's still it's a family vacation. It's a time for families to come out. We get the, I notice at our tournaments more families come. They all want to be a part of it. There's pin trading. There's things for the siblings to do. Yeah, it's a lot of fun, and we're proud of it.
It's such a great event. And now, I know you can't let the cat out of the bag, but do you have a hint about where we may see State Wars 9 this year?
You know, we're still working on finalizing things, and we had, a great tournament in St. Louis, and we will be back there shortly. But I'd say over the next couple years, we'll be in St. Louis again. We're looking to get back to Chicago. Just not sure of the order yet.
Fantastic. As you know, Canada coming in, the provinces, now we've opened it up. May we see you possibly go international?
You know, we've had a women's team from Spain has come out before to play, so we've had that. But, you know, we have Manitoba, Alberta, Ontario, British Columbia already participating. And, of course, they take a lot of pride in where they come. And, you know, we're willing to let anyone in. We have to obviously be restrictive of, you know, making sure that a team doesn't have too much of an advantage over a state team. But, you know, there's always a possibility.
Well, that's great. Ladies and gentlemen, again, my guest has been Tim McManus. He's the owner of State Wars. If you haven't checked out State Wars, make sure you do. Tim, where can we send everybody?
I would go to statewarshockey.com, or obviously we have Facebook page and Twitter pages. But statewarshockey.com is one of the info you need.
Remember, Tim didn't say it, but I have a State Wars for some roller hockey. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back after these commercial messages.
Hi, I'm Joe Norris. I have played professional ice hockey, roller hockey, and been around hockey my whole life. And when I'm a little too tired to get up and play, I watch rollerhockeytv.net because it is the bomb.
I'm Heather Josie Moore, and I'm Aaron Honto, and you're watching rollerhockeytv.net.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. MLRH International, it's halftime. Very special guests here from Labeda. I have both Kevin Labeda and Rob Chornema. Gentlemen, welcome to the show.
Hey, thanks for having us here, Doug.
Just got back from Mannheim, Germany. We had Oktoberfest. It was a huge success up there. And one of the things that I was blown away about was that the preferred wheel at Oktoberfest was Labeda. You guys are international now.
Well, it's important for us to make sure we're making good wheels, and I think everybody recognizes that. And it does, it's just not a domestic market anymore. You know, hockey's being played around the world, and roller hockey's reaching the next levels in all areas.
Fantastic. And Kevin, tell us a little bit about the rink now. I understand that you guys are opening up.
We're building a new rink right now just for testing wheels. We want to make the best product. So technology, R&D is important to us to move product and make the best.
Fantastic. They get to test them out. We're going to talk a little bit about the Labeda product because there are so many different options that you have. And what are the best options for what playing surfaces? So we're going to let Rob talk a little bit about that right now. Gentlemen?
Well, we're going to start here first with a gripper wheel. The gripper's been around for about 15, 16 years. It became the game changer in regards to how roller hockey was played on plastic tile surfaces. You know, the principles behind a gripper wheel was we had a small core, a single pore amount of urethane around the wheel, which allowed the wheel to flex. That flex gave you a bigger footprint, gave you more grip, which ultimately gave you the opportunity to skate on plastic tile surfaces, being able to do the things we're doing today based on, you know, being able to stop, take off, and so forth.
And the amazing thing over there in Germany, again, watching a lot of players were using that, especially from Team Sweden. What do we have next?
Here, another simple single pore wheel, but it's poured in our endurance urethane. So it's designed for asphalt playing to where you can still get the same type of performance on an asphalt surface for sliding, stopping, but still the grip and the wear that you'd expect, you know, from a Labeda product.
Amazing. So outdoors, good use.
Next, we have our Millennium Wheel. This is probably the next big game changer in the way the sport was played, and the fact that we created a wheel that was based on dual durometer technology. So the wheel is poured twice. You have the inner core, just like a regular wheel would be, which allows the wheel to flex. You know, at that flex point here, which is built into the design of the wheel, ultimately allowing the outer surface to be able to grip with taking the load off of the outer surface with the way the wheel flexes and so forth.
And if I'm not incorrect, this wheel started, what, the early 90s? This was the first wheel, I think, that Lebeda put in mass production?
No, this is actually the millennium being the turn at the millennium. So it was actually in 1999. The gripper was probably 95, and this being the first wheel that actually, like I said, it was a grip, speed, big advantage in regards to being able, if you didn't have that wheel at the time, you weren't winning games.
Absolutely. What do we have next, Ryan?
And now you're taking that same technology that you see in the Millennium, but to the next level in the Dynasty wheel. The difference here is you see this white speed ring that's in the center. So it's the same concept design-wise with a urethane core. So it's being poured, the yellow portion's being poured like a regular wheel would be. We then pour the singular white ring, which is a speed ring, which allows that same grip, but now you've got support through the center of the wheel, allowing the wheel to roll faster, creating a better gripping, faster all-around wheel. And now we go into our premier line, which is our Addiction wheels. Two new colorways for 2013, our new white Addiction, which is found on the Tour Fishbone skates, our yellow Addiction, both in grip, new Alkali RPD, and our design for the power skater or the heavier player who normally shreds through wheels. Them up, this wheel will be right there for them. So it's the ideal wheel for the performance player who wants wear, grip, performance without sacrificing anything. You're getting it all in the Addiction wheel.
Fantastic. And now let's talk a little bit, where can people find your products? Where can they specifically go to get all these items that you just showed?
Well, we're fortunate that we work with a great dealer base. So most of your accounts that are hockey accounts, you're going to be able to find our products in. We have great relationships with our online customers, Hockey Monkey, Inline Warehouse, Major League Roller Hockey Pro Shop.
That's absolutely right. Lebeda is the number one selling wheel in the Major League Roller Hockey Pro Shop right now.
And, you know, your Total Hockeys, your Johnny Max, if you're in a hockey, you know where you're heading for your hockey products. Lebeda is the number one wheel company in the business.
Absolutely. I'm very proud to have Lebeda back as one of our major sponsors this year. Mission Hockey, Mission Bauer Hockey, and Lebeda, the two premier sponsors of Major League Roller Hockey. Give us your website address, Rob, if people want to go check these things out for themselves and look at each product. And also, you also sell T-shirts and hats, correct?
Correct. We actually have a relationship with New Era, so all our hats are New Era products. And, you know, from your custom fits to your snapbacks, you know, we have a little bit of it all. For example, we've got one here, and, you know, we're tied into working with Team USA, so a lot of our products, being the fact that we're made in the USA, are really pushed. You're able to get into some cool-looking stuff and still support the roller hockey industry.
And we're going to talk about one more thing, which I understand is your Lebeda bearings.
Yeah, we do have a premier set of bearing line, which is our Lebeda cross packs. You know, it comes with a speed lube in there, as well as 16 bearings. You know, whether you want Swiss lights, ABEC 9, 7s, or 5s, you can find everything you need with your wheels, bearings, and component parts with Lebeda wheels.
Ladies and gentlemen, our guests have been from Lebeda, Kevin Lebeda and Rob Chornomut. Again, you can find these great products at any one of your international hockey retailers. Mannheim, Germany, I was absolutely blown away that Lebeda is the number one wheel, and the players over there in Europe absolutely love it. Again, if you want to check out their website, it's www.lebeda.com. Is that correct?
That's right.
Fantastic. Once again, Rob Chornomut, Kevin Lebeda. We'll be right back after these commercial messages.
DJ Khaled! Yes. Yeah. All I do is win, 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 no matter what. Got money on my mind, I can never get enough. And every time I step up in the building, everybody hands go up. And they stay there.
I won't stop now. Whoa. Keep your hands up, get them in. We'll be right back.
special guest. It's the brand director for Mission Bauer Hockey, Sean Riley. Sean, great to have you aboard.
Hey, Doug. Thanks for having me.
Sean's going to talk to us a little bit about the 2012-2013 Bauer line, and with you tonight you have the Inhaler Skate. Tell our viewers a little bit about it, Sean.
Yeah, we just launched the new 2012 lineup of products, obviously highlighted by the AC1 skate itself, and we've just launched in stores September 15th, and things are going fairly well for us right now. I'm pretty excited about the year ahead.
What's different with the Inhaler over the past years with different Mission brands?
Well, you know, we've had an opportunity here with Bauer coming into the picture. We've changed the launch patterns. We've gone 2 years with every product cycle. And we've had the ability to really focus on roller-specific technology with the Mission lineup versus the Vapor lineup. A great, you know, keep your feel on the wheel crossover from ice to roller to keep that ice feel you have on the ice as well. So two separate fits and two separate focuses.
And actually, this skate, ladies and gentlemen, this thing doesn't weigh anything. I can't believe, how did you get the technology? How did you do it?
Well, I think some small things to highlight, obviously, with the, you know, with the ventilation in the product. You can see the chassis. We've taken some space out of it, almost like a bridge. You know, take out the material where you don't need it, keep it where you need it to keep the support structure and the integrity in the product. So, you know, we've done some small things, and the R&D engine that we have at Bauer has really helped us, you know, elevate our game and step it up on the product front. So,
that's fantastic. Now, let's talk a little bit about Mission Bauer. You're now getting involved in IIHF. You're internationally involved. You were there in Germany last year for the IIHF Games. What's your involvement with that?
Well, you know, we've recently signed a 3-year deal with the IIHF, so for the next 3 years, we're going to continue our focus on some global growth. We've had a lot of focus on North America, and the success of roller hockey has been primarily in North America. So, you know, we're taking the show off this continent a little bit and putting some focus on some other parts of the world, because we feel like if it grows there, it'll just further, you know, stimulate the growth here in North America as well.
Not only that, ladies and gentlemen, but if you didn't know, Mission Axiom was 2 times the two-peat this year, undefeated champion in Major League Roller Hockey, $20,000 richer, right?
Yes, you know, we had a tremendous experience. You know, the league has been great for the players, added that contact element in our game and a great outlet. You know, the boys really enjoy playing that game. It's been a lot of fun for these guys to get together a weekend, and we had nothing but a ton of fun. And, you know, credit to the rest of the guys in the league, the competition in the league. We're a great team. We're tough to play every week. And these guys came out every week, especially the Arizona boys and these Vegas guys. I mean, at the time they put in, knowing what they were up against, just a great group of guys. And good to see we got guys like that in the game to keep growing this thing and try and get it to where we want it to be.
Absolutely. Major League Roller Hockey, again, you know, Mission being a very proud sponsor. Glad to have you guys back with us. Mission products. I've used Mission as long as I can go back, Sean, and you know I've been a Mission user. Just Mission continues to raise the bar in the sport and challenge everybody else to raise their level. So our guest again has been the brand director of Mission Bauer, Sean Riley. Sean, we wish you much success this year with your product line, and hopefully we'll see you on a rink soon.
Thank you very much, Doug. Thanks for having us.
Hello, I'm Garnet Alexander. I'm the skate developer for Mission and Bauer Roller Hockey. When you think about what we wanted to do this year, is we wanted to capture airflow into this skate. So we have lots of ventilation in the toe box, lots of ventilation in the quarter. Now when you think about it, when you're skating, that skate is attacking the air in front of it. So as that toe box comes cutting through the air, air is flowing in through here. Now when you look at the way that we configured the vents on the side of the quarter, they're angled out so that air comes out. So you see, as that skate is flying through the air is flowing in through this toe cap and out through the quarter vent. Now at the same time, you'll have airflow through the tongue as well. We have openings in the tongue so that air is coming in to cool off the top of your foot. So front of your foot, side of your foot, top of your foot, all of it has active ventilation. We also made changes to the chassis. So we've removed a lot of material. Now this is all material that wasn't really needed in the chassis. So by removing this material, we're saving weight. So we've got the lightest chassis we've ever made. But we haven't had to sacrifice any performance because it was all material that wasn't really being used. Think of it more like a bridge structure. We have material where it's needed, and where it's not, there's openings.
Because we're making such a bold statement with the vented quarter, with the vented toe cap, we knew that our overall design theme, it needed to show that we're confident in our product. If I had one word to describe the Inhaler series, I would say it's fresh. We have a smaller tendon, it's an asymmetrical tendon, the flowing Mission logo on the side, the true vented tongue, the new design, the new profile of the chassis, the fact that you can personalize that quarter, you can take your little marker and color in your little initial or your number on the quarter of your skate. We've thought about everything on this skate. We've tried to put everything we could possibly put into this skate, right down to the textured eyelets. It makes someone pick it up, and I know the players appreciate those little details. Or when I design this skate, the whole time I'm thinking, feel the flow that's going through your head, and I think we captured that with this skate, with this line, with the Inhaler series.
Hi, I'm Kevin Labeda.
And I'm Rob Labeda. Surfing the net.
We go to rollerhockeytv.net.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Kevin Labeda.
And I'm Rob Labeda. When we're surfing the net, we go to rollerhockeytv.net.
Let's do it again with it.
Hi, Kevin Labeda.
And I'm Rob Labeda. When we're surfing the web, we go to rollerhockey.net.
Hi, I'm Kevin Labeda.
And I'm Rob with Labeda. When we're surfing the web, we go to rollerhockeytv.net.
Hi, I'm Kevin Labeda.
And I'm Rob with Labeda. When we're searching the web, we go to rollerhockeytv.net.
Hi, I'm Kevin Labeda.
And I'm Rob with Labeda. When we're searching the web, we go to rollerhockeytv.net.
Sleeping in your bed. Am I saying my name here too?
Okay, go ahead.
Hi, I'm Philip Pritchard, and when I'm not carrying the Stanley Cup, I'm watching rollerhockey.tv.
Oh, it's rollerhockeytv.net.
Okay.
Hold on. Here we go.
This is Stephen Campbell, number 17 with the Breakaway Bullies. I'll see you out on the Major League Roller Hockey floor. Come get crushed by this guy.
Wait, hold on. Okay, that's right.
Thank you.